Hi, this is Preet from Life Invest. Today we're going to have a special guest. We're going to have an online businessman coming to us and telling us how he created his online business, how he's investing his millions, and what are his plans for future. Stay tuned till the end of the video because we're going to show you the same strategies as Alvar Rägel is using. Here we are. Let's go to the video. Hi, Alvar. Glad you can join with us here today. You have a very interesting resume. You bought a flat from us through Life Invest, but first, could you please tell us a little bit about your online business story?
Hi, thanks for having me. I used to be Amazon FBA online seller. I ran my Amazon e-commerce business around 4 years, and after that I sold it. And now I'm investing in different fields, mainly in real estate. So that's the thing how we met.
Nice. What was the number that you exited with after selling your company?
It was around 2 million euros.
Nice. What was the product? Was there many various products, or was there one certain one?
I tried out a lot of different products. I guess maybe around 30. But at the end of the day, it was like one hit wonder. I was selling insect catcher, which I was partly developing myself, partly taking the Chinese product.
Nice.
And then I put it under my brand and start to sell it on Amazon. Everything went quite nicely. Of course, had many trouble shoots as well, but finally, it's like everywhere. Finally, then I guess I was also quite tired of running that business and wanted to have cash on account. So that was the reason why I sold it, and now investing the places where I know that money is not disappearing overnight.
Yeah, exactly. So you have it in a real estate portfolio. How many units do you have in that portfolio? How many?
Around 20 today.
Around 20. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay. Nice. When did you start investing in real estate? Why? What was the reason? What attracted you to it?
Actually, it was kind of my first love. Even before I started to online business, I was interested to business in real estate. But there was different obstacles, mainly that I didn't have enough cash by that time. And it made more sense to start online business because it was needed less amount of money.
Yeah.
But now when I'm back in investing, I multiply my portfolio, and I guess the biggest part is the rental properties in Estonia.
Mm-hmm. Nice. Do you try to keep them in like one building together, or do you have them in various places around Tallinn?
I find it quite difficult to find this one building where I can invest all the money I needed. Usually, like, the first idea was to develop the building myself. I didn't find any good deal. Then I started to look around to buy properties which have already built from somebody else. And now I'm like usually putting 5 apartments in one building. So it's still quite easy to manage.
Yeah.
You can use the one manager, can do everything in one building. And also, if everything is not in the same building, it also gives you a little bit diversity. Like, maybe you have to sell it in future, and then it's good that everything is not in the same building that you can sell.
Maybe it's not doing that well, and then you get other opportunities. Right. What about investing in Estonia in general? Like, did you ever think about investing abroad somewhere, maybe? Did you have any look around?
As a typical guy who lives in cold weather country like Estonia is, I was also thinking about to buy something in Spain and maybe also live for a while there. But I did small investing, and I find out that there's maybe even more more problems to solve in Spain than in Estonia, and Estonia is also my country market. So at the end of the day, I find it more easier to keep everything together in one country where I already know the market, and I also see that probably the price is gonna go up here in future.
Yeah, exactly. I agree with you. What about generally doing business in Estonia? Do you think the government is making this happen easily, or do you find any obstacles on the way, or how do you generally feel about it, like in Estonia? Is it okay?
I think it's generally quite good environment to make business because of many things here have been digitalized. Even the notary process where you can sign the contract to buy apartment real estate, you can do it online. So I guess there's many good sides doing business in Estonia. Of course, I don't have much comparison with other countries because I've been living here since I born. So far I have heard, I feel that the that I don't want to move my business anywhere else.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, makes sense. Yeah, you're familiar with the surroundings over here. You feel comfortable. In your time that you've been investing in real estate, what have been the biggest obstacles or the biggest lessons that you've learned on the way?
I guess the main thing is that usually it happens that first business plan may not work out exactly as you thought, but you just have to start from somewhere and just move on until you finally get your result you were after.
Yeah, exactly. Learn on the way. How do you compare investing in real estate with other fields that you've been investing in? Can you bring up maybe some important differences that you can see?
Rental real estate for me is more like this good sleep investment. That I know that this money doesn't disappear overnight, and yeah, of course, the yields are not huge compared to maybe some online businesses, but it's I just like that one part of my portfolio is giving me this good sleep. And maybe the other part is more like to grow and to get some excitement.
Yeah, adrenaline running.
Purpose in life.
Exactly, I agree with you. What would you suggest to people who are thinking of starting to invest in real estate, like right now, for example?
As there's a lot of money printing in the world, we already see in Estonia as well that real estate prices have started a little bit already grow up, and we also see that so many people have got good loans from the banks and they are on the market to buy. The interest are quite high, even that we have this COVID pandemic still going around. So it seems to me that that moment may be a quite good time to buy, even if the rental prices have a little bit gone down. But I see that maybe after a year, the rents are already up again.
Covered, yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
And then
the value has gone up.
Yeah,
it's definitely looking like that. Right now, it seems to be the right time to get something. What are your next goals? Like, what are you working on at the moment? Do you plan on investing in real estate in the future again? Share any?
Yeah, sure. I guess my main goal at the moment is to finish all the investments I have at the moment, some renovations going on in some apartments, so to finish everything this and then get completely free from the space to work. So that's also the one reason why I'm investing in real estate, is that I put my effort in to set the business up, to buy the apartments, find the right people to manage them, and after that I'm free to go wherever I wish.
Passive income.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly. Right. Well, thanks, Oliver. Thank you for coming. Very interesting. Hopefully we'll see in the future and be cooperating again.
Thanks.
Thanks for watching this video. If you really liked what you saw today, then make sure to like, share and subscribe. If you want to build your heritage in Estonia using the same strategies, then download Operation Silicon Valley EU. And if you're ready to invest in Estonia, book a Life Invest case study. The link is down here in the description. Thanks for watching. See you next time.